Preventing and preventable the disease is a cornerstone of ISHO, as being mentioned, and we are going also to listen to the next speaker. Dr. Fahad has finished his talk by goals, steps, plan, and working. And one of the working or the achievement, still a preventable disease. I'd like to welcome again Dr. Fahad to talk about neonatal screening, cyanotic congenital heart disease, and hearing process. Thank you very much.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Good afternoon again. This talk, I will talk more about the universal newborn hearing screening and universal CCHD screening in Saudi Arabia. Just before that, this is my private hospital where I am practicing neonatology. It is around 400-bedded hospital. We have a small, compared with the Ministry of Health units, 23-bedded neonatal ICU. And actually, we are working, doing everything there, including pediatric and neonatal cardiac surgery and ECMO. I will talk about the successful story, although it is short and we're still in the journey, about the neonatal, universal neonatal hearing screening and the neonatal cardiac screening for congenital, critical congenital heart diseases. Actually, we start only last year, but we think in, we did a great job with the help of all the concerned people and Ministry of Health. Critical congenital heart disease defect and neonatal hearing screening, to start with the CCHD, newborn screening with pulse oximeter, aimed to improve early detection of critical congenital heart disease. And early diagnosis means early treatment, which means fewer financial and other costs. We are sticking to the international standards of screening almost the 12 structural birth defects, cyanotic congenital heart disease, which can be really serious in the beginning, and diagnosing these diseases can prevent the myocardial dysfunction, and early treatment is helpful. As we mentioned, once identified, babies with the CCHD can be seen by the cardiologist and can receive the specialized care and treatment that could prevent death or disability early in life. Treatment can include medications and or surgery. Regarding the hearing screening, my talk is not going to be about the importance of the screening, because it is well established and many countries are doing it, and it is a standard of care in more than one of the countries. So I will concentrate on establishing the program and how we can empower and improve our services by doing this service to every delivery. So universal neonatal hearing screening is one of the hearing loss is one of the most common congenital anomalies, occurring in approximately 2 to 4 infants per 1,000. And as you know, early identification before 6 months and intervention can prevent severe psychosocial, educational, and long-term sequelae of hearing loss. So it was easy for us for the hearing screening, because there was a royal order to screen babies for all babies for hearing, and this was implemented by the Saudi Health Council, requested by the Saudi Health Council, and again requested by the Ministry of Health to the governmental and non-governmental hospitals to do the screening for all babies. So the order is ready, and we have to implement. So this makes our journey easy in regard to the hearing screening. Again, the number of babies in Ministry of Health is almost static, and it is around a quarter a million baby every year. So when we decide to start the hearing screening and CCH screening, it was discussed actually in the our meeting the Advisory Committee for Developing or Improving Neonatal Services, and there was a discussion about agreeing on this or not. So the initial steps to review the evidence for both screens and to review the needs, review the local experience, and review the international experience took us around 9 months before we decide to go ahead and start the official approval submission to the Ministry of Health. After that, we get the approval from Ministry of Health to go ahead, but believe me, this was the first of the challenge, not the end of the story. So the first step we did to maximize the efficiency of our programs is to get as much as we can of the higher authority support. We went to the minister, but unfortunate during that time there was changes, very quick changes of the ministers. So there was almost 5 or 6 ministers of health, and we were not succeeded on this. Every time we will discuss with one, there will be a change. So we went to the deputy minister and we get his support. We describe the program thoroughly, and we send also a letter to the Saudi Health Council explaining what we're supposed to do and how we are going to implement it. Furthermore, we get the approval of the hospitals and General Directorate of Hospitals to request and send a letter to all the hospitals and Ministry of Health that this is mandatory programs and they have to follow the international standards on this regards. And one more step is the nursing department or General Directorate of Nursing in Ministry of Health. We ask them to send a letter to all the nurses departments in the different hospitals to make this program as part of the nursing daily work in the postnatal ward. And this was submitted and it was very supportive for us. The next step was to formulate teams, and we formulated two, the supervisor team in the Ministry of Health for both the CCHD and hearing, including a neonatologist and cardiology or ENT and audiologist, to supervise overall the program and to help on relieving any obstacles or obstruction in the way of implementing the programs. And we ask every hospitals, to submit their members, including a neonatologist or pediatrician and a nurse and cardiologist or ENT or audiologist. So it was submitted, and we decided to start in phases. So, and we chose the 2080 way to start. So we have actually 30 referral hospitals accounting for almost more than 65% of the Ministry of Health deliveries. So we decided to make those 30 hospitals as level one in our program, and in phase two, we decided to make all the referral hospitals, all the other remaining hospitals. So these are the list of referral major hospitals and Ministry of Health included in phase one, and we submit the request directly to them. We put together our national guidelines with the help of cardiologists and the audiology and the ENT people, we put together almost 6 pages of guidelines for the CCHD, describing and clearly how you need to do the critical congenital heart disease screening, and another 5 pages on the hearing screening and the way to do the universal neonatal hearing screening. Again, we maximize the partnership with the companies, and we sign a consumable deal with the companies, with both the cardiac and hearing, with the free screening equipment to all sites, training and retraining Ministry of Health teams, a smart software connected to the centralized database in Ministry of Health, 24/7 maintenance of equipment and responding to calls, maintenance of the softwares and educational material for both staff and families, and an annual advanced workshop for both CCHD and hearing. The communication is one of the struggles always. So how to improve the communications? Thanks for the technology. We make a WhatsApp group, actually, which is very effective now. In the WhatsApp group, more than 230. And you will throw the question, for example, from Al-Grayat, and you will find the answer in no time from Najran or Asir. And this was really very helpful, and it is working 24 hours in an unbelievable way. Collecting the data, we are proud that we have one of the really unique collecting data system, special screening program, and the database is in Ministry of Health in Riyadh with a web-based page can be accessed from anywhere in the hospitals. When we will give the access, then the nurse, if she is eligible for both hearing and cardiac, she can see this page, which show the screening for both. There is some information about the mother, then the result of the hearing screening and CCHD. We integrate the protocol in this software, so what will be in the machine, it will be implemented here. If there is a rejection on the machine, it will be rejected on the four-second repeat on the software, and then she will do it again. For quick feedback, we are sending a feedback monthly report to every hospital, and with the number of babies delivered and screened, and the percentage of screening in both cardiac and hearing, and also a printable copy for reporting the result for both of them. Any defect, any referral case will drop immediately in the doctor's box, where the doctor will open and see the cases dropped either in the hearing or in the cardiac, and he will follow this patient and till they close the file. The report, including the number of delivery by Ministry of Health records and the number of babies screened, for example, in this case, the percentage is 93, and the report will be sent to the hospital as you have a site screening of 93% of your delivery. Furthermore, we will send this comparison sheet to compare all the referral hospitals with another comparison sheet to compare all the small hospitals to everybody, including the minister, in monthly basis, and the general directorate of all the areas, so they will know, and the directorate of hospitals to know where they are and to push if there is any need for administrative support for this program. Appreciation of the team is very important, so a quick feedback to the local team is one of the important things that we have to do. Appreciation in the group, appreciation letters to the hospital and to the people, and appreciation certificate in addition to a free invitation to conferences for the best people on the screening. So what is our achievement? Actually, we start in 2016, so we are new in the screening, and this is the CCHD. There was a dramatic improvement over the last year, and the same thing on the hearing screening. There was great improvement. This was the first month when we start, and there was a real struggle, and this is the December last year. We were able to screen more than 91,000 in hearing, and the cardiac, this was the first month for the 30 referral hospitals, and this was the result in December, and we were able to screen more than 112,000 baby in the referral hospitals. This is the evaluation or the position of Saudi Arabia before 2016 as a country interested on screening and CCHD, and fortunately this is the updated one. We are the only country outside the state and Europe with the national recommendation, and it is a mandatory screening for CCHD. The next step is our journey for 3 years and between 2017 and December 2019. We are planning for 3 years project, aiming for screening more than 750,000 newborn, with adding all Ministry of Health hospitals to the program and monitoring all the private hospitals, and to ensure the quality of screening with the close follow-up of all referred cases. Actually, if we achieve things, in 2016, I am proud that we established the program, and now we are concentrating on the quality of this program over the coming few years, inshallah. The challenges, actually screening, to ensure screening 100% of newborn babies, and we are discussing now connecting this screening with the metabolic screening, also with the birth certificate for all deliveries, actually, and to ensure 100% screening. And frequent challenges in the local screening team changes, actually, and this is really a challenge when we will train a nurse and then they will be moved from the screening. Improving data entry and reducing human errors. We are working with both companies to integrate the system with no human entry on the system, just flowing the data from the machine directly to the our system to ensure there is no or to reduce the human error. Close monitoring of the referred cases and monitoring the missed cases and the false negative cases, reporting these cases back to the Ministry of Health. The availability of diagnostic facility in both screen, the audiologist and the echo facility in the hospitals, and fixing the referrals for both screening. I know it is a challenge, and it is a continuous really challenge, but for our future nation, it is really deserved. I want to thank the team who is working with us on this screening, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Fahad.